We've talked a lot about Darth Vader and Exegol. Issue number 10 revealed Darth Vader landing on Exegol, but not only that, mind-tricking a Suma Verminoth to bend to his will and send him to the Sith Citadel. Now, what will he encounter there will be something spectacular, I think, on April 28th when Darth Vader number 11 will come out. By encountering the Eye of Webbish Bog, Vader took the Sith Wayfinder that eventually would lead him to Exegol with the help of the Sith assassin, Ochi of Bestoon, who was sent by Sidious. All this ruse smells like the works of Palpatine. There is a moment where it is revealed that the Eye of Webbish Bog is directly connected to Palpatine as well, so at this point Sidious is shown to be an intergalactic being. He is capable of communicating and feeling everything around him, including the galaxy. Which is kind of OP, but it serves for the story specifically, as Darth Vader now travels to Exegol, and the main question of course should be, what will Darth Vader encounter on Exegol? Because this does not mean that Vader will see everything we saw in The Rise of Skywalker. You have to remember that that is about 40 years after the events of Return of the Jedi. With that being said, this leads us to believe that 40 years before that, Exegol might be completely different. Therefore, we might see things that were not shown in the film, and that is the most exciting part, especially since Darth Vader will get to live them through and digest everything that he sees there, which I assume it's gonna be mind-boggling even for Darth Vader knowing Palpatine and what he is capable of. Let's start by saying that Exegol was a desolate world, covered with enormous fissures that reached deep into the crust of the planet. These were excavated by Sith loyalists who were attempting to reach a transportive vergence they believed to lie beneath the surface. It was first mentioned by a Jedi writer, Klee the Elder, in the book Ramahgon. The planet was titularly named Exegol, or as Klee wrote it, Exegol with an I. This planet used to have a fertile environment back in the day until the Sith established their presence there and laid waste to the planet, just as they did with Korriban, Zyost, and Asog. Among various changes that the Sith made was the creation of a massive underground shipyard. What you have to understand first is that this dates back at least 1,000 years. Even back then, Exegol became a Sith bastion. Every Sith loyalist and Sith explorer would somehow or another travel to Exegol. This was thousands of years before the fall of the Galactic Empire. Under the Sith rule, the Sith Citadel was built on Exegol for meetings and rituals which were to be conducted within it, and Sith loyalists excavated the world's largest and deep planetary fissures in hope of reaching this vergence believed to lie beneath the planet's surface. This is one of the first things I believe that Darth Vader will encounter while he is on Exegol. It is this Sith Citadel which will leave him speechless, especially considering what happens inside of it. Imagine the rituals that Darth Vader will see by these Sith loyalists. Hopefully, of course, they will be there, since this is again 40 years before what we see in Rise of Skywalker. Now, the most intriguing part for me, what Darth Vader could see there, are the remains of Darth Noctis and Darth Sanguis. You see, the most intriguing part to me about Exegol is that according to legend, according to stories, there were these two Sith lords that reached Exegol in their quest for immortality. In the 2020 book Dark Legends, in the Life Immortal story, Darth Sanguis makes his appearance. He was a male Sith Lord who, again, according to legend, traveled to Exegol seeking to learn the secrets of immortality. This, of course, is nothing new about the Sith. We knew about their quest for immortality back in Revenge of the Sith, since Sidious wanted the secrets for himself. The craziest part, though, is that Darth Sanguis traveled to Exegol and actually achieved his goal. Through some manner, he really became immortal. The sad part about it, though, is that Darth Sanguis transformed into a creature over time, into an unrecognizable monster. So without divulging too much, we can clearly understand that while you can achieve immortality in Star Wars, you have to pay a price. This is a similar story to Gollum as well. While holding on to the One True Ring, throughout the centuries, he became a disfigured creature, unrecognizable from what he was before. His salvation came in the form of Darth Noctis. Darth Noctis was a female Sith Lord who, according again to legend, traveled to Exegol seeking immortality similar to Darth Sanguis, and by the time Noctis arrived at Exegol, the legend of Darth Sanguis had all but disappeared, since he has been living alone on this planet for what we can assume is centuries. Noctis went on to encounter Darth Sanguis, who did not reveal his real identity to Darth Noctis just yet. He simply offered her servitude to Darth Noctis, eventually becoming her servant. Deep in Exegol's crust, Noctis discovered Sanguis's lab and took note of some of the rituals that were done there. After much study, she completed the 3-day ritual. This led her to become immortal, but in order to become immortal, she needed to sacrifice Sanguis and kill him. This happened without Darth Noctis knowing the true purpose of Sanguis' immortality. You see, him transforming into a creature over the centuries that he lived through, he was living in a miserable existence. He was a monster that had no purpose to his immortality. The only way to pass it through was for somebody to kill him, and this somebody became Darth Noctis. After she killed Sanguis, she not only relieved him of his pain, as he now was dead and free from his horrible existence, the ritual itself then twisted Darth Noctis into a creature similar to what Sanguis had become previously. While Vader could encounter the remains of Darth Sanguis and maybe even Darth Noctis, who is still alive on that planet, being immortal and all, the labs that Sanguis had built on Exegol might be another plot point for Darth Vader to push his story through. Can Darth Vader be tricked by Noctis as well and become immortal, however suffer the same fate as these two Sith? So far, canon has clearly set up a great story for us to see in issue number 10. I'm honestly gonna lose my mind if Darth Vader encounters Darth Noctis there, who is still living after hundreds if not a thousand years, being there all alone by herself. I truly think it's going to be spectacular if that actually happens, but guys, let me know what do you think as well. Will Darth Vader encounter the Sith Citadel there, maybe some Sith Loyalist, or even Darth Noctis? Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you enjoyed, leave a thumbs up down below, subscribe for dailies. Now you can have an awesome day, Star Wars fans. I'll see you in the next video, and may the Force be with you. Until then.